أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Why not? Let me try it, see if my life would be better. Let me try Islam. Of course, with the current events in the last 100 years, from the time of colonization, no efforts has been spared to tarnish the image of Islam, and connected with it all kind of things, all the way to terrorism. Islam has nothing to do with terrorism. All these terrorists are either sick people or misguided people or mercenaries or you name it. But Islam and the teaching of Islam, which has been documented in books for 1,400 years, has no place in it for violence or taking the law in your own hand or fighting wars without a government and a Congress and a decision by the whole country. Period. And anyone who is interested, he can review some of my talks in the past. So let me then discover the medicine, Islam the medicine. It's tempting to try it because, number one, you can do it by yourself in secret without even anybody knows. And it costs nothing. It's free. And there's a nice statement which says, which is sweeter than honey? The answer is free vinegar. So this is something which is free. You don't need anyone to manage your soul and your money and to manage your family or abuse your family. No institutions like organized religion. And all these figures from the third world countries, they're supposed to be teachers, but they take the role of religious holy men. And in Islam, there is no holy men. There's human beings with all the deficiencies of human beings. Of course, they can manage or control brains and masses. This is a fact. We see it with the Nazi and with the communist. Human beings can be easily prey to those kind of people, from Rasputin and all the way, all those sheikhs and priests and you name it. Schopenhauer one time said the doctors make their money from the sick people, the lawyers from conflicts and problems, but those holy men from the stupidity and naive people who give their paycheck for their leader to buy a $35 million plane, airplane. He has one for cost $25 million, but he's tired of it. Well, anyone is free to be cheated or to be treated as stupid, and we're living in a free time, free country, free century. So Islam is free. Even how about the zakah, which is 2.5% of the saved money, which you don't need. Of course, the zakah is one of the pillars of Islam, but it's under your control, and you distribute that thing, and the best to give it to your family, not the ones you are responsible for, like your parents or your children. Give it to whoever in need in your family. So it is something you do it, not 10% or 20% for those holy men to manage, and they accumulate wealth in billions of dollars. So in Islam, we don't have that. It's personal. You do it yourself. And you give charity and zakah and on your own desire and whim. So in Islam, we don't have middlemen, we don't have institutions, and we don't have anyone to handle you, to manage your soul. But yourself and your relation is with your creator directly. And everything is outlined very beautifully, very concise way, and books are available everywhere. And of course, what's the risk? Nothing. If it doesn't work for you, great. You had a nice experience. You might have met one or two nice people or Muslims, and that would be the end of it. Maybe we can solve some of our problems. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.